Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. Today I am going to discuss about a project which is built on machine learning with the help of OpenCV with DNN model. I had uploaded this project some days back, but I think that some guys are getting doubts in the code. So today I am going to explain everything line to line. Watch the video till the end so you don't be with any doubts. And guys, if you have not subscribed our channel, please subscribe the channel for more machine learning related videos. So guys, I am going to start explaining code. First of all guys, here I am giving you brief introduction about the project. In this project I have made a face detection model. We can detect the face in any image, and we are using a pre-trained model which is of DNN module, which will detect faces for us. So guys, let's start with the code. First of all, I am importing here all the necessary libraries. First library is NumPy, second is argparse. So guys, what actually argparse is? It is a library used for taking command line argument in Python. So we are using to take image as a command line argument from the user. And next library is CV2, which is OpenCV library used for pre-processing the image and enhancing or edge detection and many such functionalities. So guys, next we are creating an object of argparse so that we can add the command line argument. In next line we are adding an argument which is command line, and we can specify the image name by two parameters. Either we can use single hyphen e or we can use double hyphen image. Actually guys, it is not predefined. We can use anything in place of this. So I preferred using a shorthand as well as a longhand for this argument. And guys, third argument is required. Required is true. That means you have to specify this argument to run the code. And help is guys used when we want to see documentation. Then this line will print part 2 input image, which will help the user how to run the code. Then in the next line guys, args equal to vars ap dot parse args. In this line, whatever argument user will pass after hyphen I or double hyphen image, it will be passed to args variable. So guys, next I am printing that loading model, and this is an important function guys, cv2.dnn dot read from net cafe, read net from cafe. This function actually takes two arguments. First argument is a proto.txt text file, and next argument is the model. So guys, these both files I had received from the CNN DNN module. I will provide you link for my GitHub repo from where you can download these two files. Here, this cafe model is a predefined or pre-trained model for face detection. I am using it directly. Then in next line, image equal to cv.imreadargs of image. Actually, whatever argument user is passing the image name and extension, we are accepting from args of image, and we are reading that image and we are storing in a variable named image. Then guys, for the better view, better display, I am using a predefined width and height 600 by 500, so we are resizing the window. Then guys, as we all know, if you run image.save, the save will return three values, that is height, width and lastly channels. So we need the height and width of the image, that's why we are slicing it like colon 2, so it will ignore the third value. Then we are using cv2.dnn.blob from image. Actually, what is blob from image? It is a function which is used to take the image as an input in our DNN module. So guys, I will talk about the arguments of this function now. First argument is the image. So we are here resizing the image to a fixed height and width so that our DNN module will get all the images of that dimensions 300 by 300. The second argument is scaling factor. Actually, scaling factor is a factor that scale up or scale down the image according to the value that is provided. Here we are providing 1.0, so that means that we are not applying any kind of scaling. Then guys, third argument is the height and width of the image that is necessary to be passed. So we had mentioned 300 by 300 the height and width of the image. And the last argument is guys, mean subtraction. Actually, what is mean subtraction? For any image to pass in a DNN module, we need to normalize it. To normalize it for every model, we have fixed RGB values. So for this model, the fixed RGB values are 104, 177 and 123. So every image will be subtracted from this mean subtraction value. You can find this in the proto.txt file of every model, guys. So this was the first step where we loaded the model. Now we are computing object detection. So guys, net.set input block. Here we are setting the image as an input in our model. Now guys, this is the main part of the code. Detection equal to net.forward. As we all know that in CNN, we have to do forward propagation as well as backward propagation. So for detection we use forward propagation, and for updation of bias and weight we use backward propagation. We had a pre-trained model, so we are only going to use forward propagation. So now net.forward will return four values. That is very important to know guys. First value is not of our use, so I am not mentioning that. Second value is frame. Now third value is number of detections. That how many faces will our model detect. It will return that number integer. Now guys, fourth argument is a list. This list consists of seven elements. First element is guys class ID, then class score, then third is confidence score, means that detection is how contains how much score. Then guys, last four elements will be the dimensions of that detection. So guys, we are going to loop over all the detections. For example, in an image we found five faces. So we will loop over all the detections and then we will calculate the confidence. So in range function we pass 0 comma detection dot shape of 2. As we can see in comment here, detection of 2, detection dot shape of 2 contains number of detection. So it will loop through the number of detection it had detected while running the model. Now next we are calculating the confidence score guys. Here as you can see detections, in detection I told you earlier that we had only four arguments. First argument is not of our use, so we is maintaining it as zero. Second argument is frame, we are also keeping it zero. Third argument is guys number of detection. So we are looping over the number of detection. So I will contain the current detection. And guys, what actually is true? So if you look at fourth argument, we have a list. If we go through the list, at second index we have confidence score. So it means that it will detect the confidence score and it will return to the variable confidence. So we are calculating confidence of each detection. And we are running a conditional statement. If the value of confidence is greater than 0.5, it means that if the accuracy of that face being detected is 50 more than 50%, then we are going to print a box around that face and going to show in our image. So guys, next few lines we are using to draw the box. As you can see here, detections 0, 0, i, 3, 7. Guys, 3, 7 here is representing the x, y, h, w, that is our four coordinates. That is our guys here, you can see I had mentioned earlier, this is the coordinates of the face and we are multiplying it with width and height of the image. Why we are doing this? Because as I mentioned earlier, we are applying mean subtraction and subtracting the RGB values from mean subtraction value, so the image is normalized. So we have to get the original pixels. For that we are doing this step. Now as box will contain the four dimensions of the rectangle which is to be printed around the face, so we are extracting that, we are unpacking that values and storing it in start x, start y and x and y. Now guys, we are also printing the confidence score in text. So here I am multiplying the confidence by 100 for ease of user. If it will return 0.45 or 0.70, then it will display 70% like this. And guys, this Y line, it calculate the dimension or it calculate the coordinates from where we have to start writing the text. Then we are guys drawing the rectangle and we are putting the text. Guys, this is easy code and this is predefined functions put text and rectangle. I am not going to explain this. You can refer OpenCV documentation or you can comment us so we could made another video on OpenCV. Guys, now last step, we are then outputting the image. And what will CV2.wait key will do until we press Q or cross, till then the image will be displayed to us. So guys, I am running this code. I will just press F5. So here guys, we can see that our image has classified all the faces in the image. This is the code that I had uploaded. You can find the link in description. And for any query guys, you can comment us. We will be available for you. Thank you guys for watching this tutorial. We will be up, stay tuned and we will be up soon.